Welcome to Coming Home. I'm honored to be here with a Patriot great in Kenny Trapp. Played two seasons at DBU, a draft pick of the Red Sox in 2001. And Kenny, let's talk about your 2 years as a Patriot. That ball club in 2000, 2001, deep runs to the NAIA World Series. Just take us through those 2 years and the type of ball clubs that you had those two years.
Yeah, in 2000, you know, we were still, I guess, provisional Division One, so we had half a schedule against some of the top major programs in the country, and then still had NAIA games, and we got off to a rough start. I think we were like 5-6 or 5-7 to start, and then we went on a roll where we won, you know, 17 or 18 games in a row, and that kind of got us going through the middle part of that year. And then towards the end of the year, we had played some high quality opponents, so towards regionals and stuff, we were ready for that. But what most people don't realize is we got beat in the first game of regionals that year, and had to go through the loser's bracket. So we battled back through. We had actually, I blew the save. That was the only save I ever blew in college. So it was a little different. We were up 4-2, and I blew it, and we lost. So it was a little disappointing there. And then we battled back through. And I think the last day, John Browder threw nine shutout innings to get in the winner's game. And then I threw 11 shutout. We threw a 20 inning shutout game, a doubleheader to get to the World Series. And so it was awesome. And then we got to the World Series and played really well. Won that first game actually in extra innings against St. Thomas, which kind of got us over that hump. And then we rolled through and ended up losing the national championship. But it was a heck of a year and awesome to be a part of for sure.
Well, that 2001 team, your stat line was incredible that year. You won 14 games. You had 10 complete games, which is something you just never see anymore. And I know you talked about being a closer and then also now on the mound as a starter. What was your mindset when you did take the mound?
Well, we just knew, you know, we didn't have as many arms as I think we had like basically six or seven guys that threw and mainly like five. So when you went in, it was, you were going in. I mean, you knew that you were going to have to throw a complete game, and I didn't expect anything else. So we just did what we could and just had that mindset of, hey, you're going to have to complete the game and even maybe come in later in the week as a closer or whatever you had to do. It was just part of it. And they, you know, a lot has changed since then. You got guys that, you know, most starters only go five or six innings now, it seems like, because of matchups and all, you know, all that. But yeah, we just love that. I just love that part of it where I got to feel like you had the ball the whole game no matter what, and it's just what it was.
Outside of the game of baseball, it's a really unique story that you have. When you just think about this program, how has DBU baseball and really this university, how has it helped change your life?
Yeah, I wasn't a believer before I got here. You know, I didn't grow up in the church. My parents didn't push that on us. I had great parents, but when I got here, I knew something was different with my coaches. We came in with like 40 guys, I think, and a lot of JUCO guys, and there was a new coaching, new head coach, and all new coaches. So when we got here, I think we lost like 15 guys the first 2 or 3 weeks. We didn't even touch a baseball. They basically put us through like a workout for just trying to weed guys out to see who was committed. And so I made it through that part of that cut, I guess. It was really difficult. But then I guess after about a month or so, I was like, all right, something's different. Either I'm going to leave this university and go on my own way, or what am I going to do? So I was actually leaving campus one night and just going home. I was done and just tired of it. I thought, this isn't for me. And then obviously seeing the sign, "Will you follow me," when I was driving off campus, just broke me down. So it was life-changing for me to, you know, and then that next day I accepted Christ with a couple of teammates, and so it was awesome, awesome experience.
It's great hearing that story, and great now the fact that you're still at DBU. So you've been here as the head golf coach now for 14 years. You've taken the men's and women's teams to five combined national tournaments. What does it mean to you to have that type of success at a university that clearly has meant so much to your life?
Yeah, it's just, it's awesome to say the least. I mean, it's, you know, you love it and you're passionate about not only goes on with golf, but you're passionate about the whole university. It's more like a family. So just being involved since, you know, basically 1999 playing and then coming back and being able to start golf with men and women has just been, you know, building those relationships just like the coaches did with me, and just trying to make a lifelong impact on these kids is awesome. And then obviously to be able to have success and trying to win national championships these last few years has been ultra special for sure.
That's Patriot legend Kenny Trapp. He is the current men's and women's golf coach, also 2001 All-American here with DBU Baseball, and this has been Coming Home.